And now, a UZ special report.
Hi, Michelle Carnley. I'm here with Gulf Coast legend and producer Ty Bracken. How you doing today?
Hey, Michelle. Good to be here. Good to be here.
Well, I want to talk to you a little bit about your Hall of Fame that you got going on here, the Rockabilly Hall of Fame. Tell us how it felt the day that you got the announcement.
Couldn't believe it. You know, I figured it must be a mistake here. And then I called the Rockabilly Hall of Fame up in Burns, Tennessee, between Nashville and Memphis, kind of the rockabilly capital of where it all started at. And sure enough, I was inducted into the Hall of Fame. Sure was. And I couldn't believe it.
Well, tell us a little bit about your music history and how it all got started and how that proceeded to get you into the Rockabilly Hall of Fame.
Well, whenever I was a kid, I played piano in church and even formed a Hickory Holler Quartet. And we would travel with the Gospel Melody Quartet, which later became the Florida Boys. And then I started playing with a band called the Rockettes. We would play Kim Strand shift break parties. We'd play at clubs up in Flemington, Alabama. And we would, we also had a Saturday morning radio show, 30-minute radio show up in Brewton, Alabama, WBJ. And that was the first step in my, I guess you would say, professional career. After then, we formed a band called the Ravens Band, which consists of myself, Johnny McGee, Jimmy Collins, Johnny Lowe, and after Johnny became Larry Harden. He was a drummer. And Johnny and I later on recorded several songs together under the name of Tybee and Johnny. And some of those songs that we recorded back in the early days, including my first song, is now sold in the UK on 8 different record labels. And the sales were so great that everybody that was on those albums got inducted into the Rockabilly Hall of Fame.
That's very cool.
And they're still selling them in the UK on several different record labels. Of course, I'm not getting any money out of it because copyrights were just good for 20 years back in those days. And unless you renewed the copyrights, you could lose the song. They became public domain. That was about it. Johnny and I played together for about 4 years, and he moved away to Gadsden, Alabama, and did his own thing. Of course, I stayed in the Pensacola area doing my own thing. Played at the Wagon Wheel in Atmore for 21 years, and that should be a Guinness's World Record somehow or another, I don't know. But then we moved from the Wagon Wheel back into Pensacola and played a lot of places in Pensacola. We was never out of a job, always had a job waiting on us, and we were very fortunate. I'd only missed 2 nights playing, one when my dad died, other times when my boss man took me out to Las Vegas. And since he was my boss man, I could get off that night.
Well, you can't beat that, can you? Now, you mentioned Tybee and Johnny. Now, we have an article here that was recently put out talking about it. And it mentions the song Meaner Than an Alligator. Is that the song that you were talking about?
Yeah, that's the song that Johnny and I did. Johnny wrote the song, but we did it, you know, together as a duo. And so that's the one that actually got us inducted into the Hall of Fame. Johnny's in the Hall of Fame also, but I have a couple of pages in there. And Johnny's contacted me this past week, and he's doing good. He's still living in Gadsden. He's like myself. He's getting old. I don't know. I didn't think I was nearly as old as he was, but I found out that I am. It's about 2 or 3 years difference in us, I guess.
Well, I'll tell you what. With your new video that you have out, This Little Light of Mine, you couldn't prove that you're old by any means. You have broken UZ history. So tell us how you feel about that.
Oh, it's just wonderful. And I'd like to thank all my fans out there, and thanks to you and Phil and Tommy for plugging it the way you have. Y'all have just been great. And I'd like to say big kudos and thank yous to everybody involved.
Now, what made you decide to do that song?
Well, I was trying to turn against my old wicked ways that I've always lived all my life. And back in church now, so I just thought I'd do a little rockabilly style gospel song. And it's an old standard that old people and young people can relate to. It's an old standard. And I just thought I'd do it, and I recorded it, and then you and Phil took a hold of it. The rest is history now, and I'm real proud that it's done as good as it has.
Well, it's a very cool video. It has a lot of the old photos of you and some of the Ravens band and you and Glenda and things like that. So it's a really nice little video.
Well, speaking of Glenda, I couldn't have ever done this without her. All these years since I hired her in 77, she's just been a great, great asset to keeping me going, because she was the lead vocalist of the band, and she's the one that did all the PR and hard work, and all I did was just try to keep the guys straight. And again, thank you all and all the fans for making this what it has been. It's been something else. Lived all my life, never, I thought it was just over, you know, and then all this comes about, and it's just rejuvenated me a little bit. But it's a happy trip right now, happy trip.
Now, you've received a lot of media about your Rockabilly Hall of Fame, so tell us a little bit about that.
Well, first of all, WEAR-TV news crew came out to my studio, and they shot for about an hour and a half and finally got about a 30-second segment of it. But I was real thankful to WEAR. They did a real nice commentary on it. And then Bill Gamblin with Santa Rosa Press Gazette, he came over and he did a very long interview with me. And as you can see, it made front page of the Santa Rosa Press Gazette. In fact, it carries the front page and also half of page 6A. So thank you, Bill, for doing a great job. Thank you so much.
Now, if people want to find out a little bit more about you and about the Rockabilly Hall of Fame, how can they find that out?
Well, you can go online at rockabillyhall.com/TY BRACKEN, and it'll take you right to the website.
Well, thank you so much. I appreciate you joining me today.
Thank you, Michelle.
The UZ Top 10 is based on the request line, Talk on the Streets, and the UZ Artist Survey.